Jesus' heart was moved with mercy to the cross of today's gospel. By mercy, he continues to extend all corners of the world, including right here. Let's take a moment to pause on minor sins and trust in the mercy. Lord Jesus, you are our help and salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you intercede for us before God the Father. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again to break the bonds of death. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let's give the Lord glory and praise this all.
shepherds, who mislead and scatter the flock of my pasture, says the Lord. Therefore, thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, against the shepherds who shepherd my people, who have scattered my sheep and driven them away. You have not cared for them, but I will take care to punish your evil deeds. I myself will gather the remnant of my flock from all the lands to which I have driven them and bring them back to their meadow. There they shall increase and multiply. I will appoint shepherds for them who will shepherd them, so that they need no longer fear and tremble, and none shall be missing, says the Lord. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up a righteous shoot to David. As king, he shall reign and govern wisely. He shall do what is just and right in the land. In his days, Judah shall be saved. Israel shall dwell in security. This is the name they give him: the Lord, our justice. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, in Christ Jesus, you who were far off have become near by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace, he who made both one and broke down the dividing wall of enmity through his flesh, abolishing the law with his commandments and legal claims, that he might create in himself one new person in place of the two, thus establishing peace, and might reconcile both with God in one body through the cross, putting that enmity to death by it. He came and preached peace to you who are far off, and peace to those who are near. For through him, we both have access in one spirit to the Father. The word of the Lord.
Obviously, we take our salvation very seriously, but we even
as ministers in the church have to take that very seriously, to preach the gospel message, the teaching of the church, and the commandments again, guidelines to our salvation. The loving God with all our heart, soul, strength, and mind, and loving our neighbor as ourselves. Seeing the face of Christ in everyone, and loving again, and trusting the Lord in everything we do. And so he says, you know, if these shepherds are not successful, if they are doing their own will, following their own carnal desires, they're out. And he says very clearly, I will appoint shepherds who will shepherd them, who will shepherd the people of Israel, and of course today they will bring the gospel message and the truth, beauty, goodness of the church to the world. And so, again, these are serious words by the Lord to teach the gospel, preach the gospel, and again, to lead people to Christ, who is the way, the truth, the life, and the one and only way to salvation. It says today in Ephesians, in Christ Jesus, you were once far off and been brought near through the blood of Christ. The Lord, as we know, suffered and died on the cross for our salvation and redemption for everyone in the history of the world. That's how much he loves us. But we've been brought near through the blood of Christ. The Lord, again, died on the cross. His blood was for all of us, for the whole world. And we have been brought near to the Lord. The Lord wants us to be near. He wants us to be close to him. He wants us to have powerful relations with him. As it says also later on, it is he is our peace. The Lord is our peace. He is our hope. He is our salvation. He is our light. So again, he's with us always until the end of the age. He'll never abandon us. So we walk by faith and not by sight. And just moment by moment, day by day, stepping with the Lord, trusting in his love and mercy. Because again, nothing more powerful than the love and mercy of God as exhibited when he died on the cross. But again, rose from the dead, proving that death has no power over him, and death has no power over us who walk with the Lord. Their lives. So today's gospel lot, so from Mark, the apostles were sent out to preach the gospel, to proclaim Jesus Christ, and so they were curing the sick, raising the dead, curing the lepers, doing all those things, all these miracles that came from the Lord. And so, but now they're exhausted. They have all these people around them. They're completely exhausted, like it says in today's gospel. They didn't even have time to eat. So the Lord says, he says, go by yourself to an out-of-way place and rest a while. So again, they're exhausted. So that message is to all of us as well. We need to have time to rest. In our busyness of life, we need that time to have a good night's sleep, good exercise, healthy diet, so that we can be the best version of ourselves, the best Catholic Christian version of ourselves, to trust in the Lord and have that balance in our life. And so the apostles are going out. And so the Lord, he sees all these people out there. And his heart is filled with pity because many are lost and forsaken. And so he's like, he is the shepherd for the sheep. The Lord is the good shepherd and who guides his flock if we allow him to do that. So it says he began to teach them at great length. So he was present to the people. His words had power and great wisdom. And he's talking about himself. He is the way, the truth, and life, the one and only way to salvation. He is the Son of God who came into the world. And so his power and that love of the Lord, he's teaching the people to love, to be compassionate, and to see the face of Christ in everyone around them, and to see the face of Christ in their own hearts and souls as well. But again, it's that time length and spending time with him because he loves them, just like he loves us. He wants to be near to him. And he is never so near than in the Eucharist as we celebrate in every Mass throughout the world, which is truly a miracle. His bread and wine become the body, blood, soul, and divinity. Jesus Christ. And this weekend is the Eucharistic Congress in Indianapolis. Thousands of people there from all over the country. Earlier today, before the confessions, I was watching some of them. They were having a Eucharistic procession in downtown Indianapolis with again thousands of people. And so they were praising the Lord and adoring the Lord. And so we ask the Lord to continue to bless everyone there with the fire of the Holy Spirit within them, to have that profound relationship with the Lord in our lives, and to pray for ourselves as well. One of the comments that was made by a commentator was talking about a religious sister who said, give the Lord an inch. Give the Lord an inch and watch what happens. So that's, you know, we open our minds and hearts to the Lord. But, you know, give the Lord an inch to love him more, to serve him more, to serve others more, and again, to see the face of Christ in everyone that we encounter. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Together, let us confess our faith. I believe in God, Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, God not made, consubstantial of the Father.
Water, air, and land we enjoy. We pray to
example, we might spread love and hope to all who meet. We ask this in Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, myself. sacrifice brought to completion buried offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy, as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that with each is offered to the honor of your majesty, and benefit the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. We know it belongs your boundless glory, that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned us a remedy out of mortality itself. The cause of our downfall had become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through the host of angels adores your majesty, rejoices in your presence forever. Your voice we pray, join with theirs, in one chorus of exalted praise. recognize the sacrifice depicted by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. And that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, filled with this Holy Spirit, and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with the elect, especially with the most, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles and Glorious Martyrs, St. Helena, and with all the saints, whose constant intercession and presence we rely on faith and help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, Lord, advance peace and salvation to all the world. Please confirm in faith and charity the Pilgrim Church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and us, and Anthony, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people of the day, your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom we have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, our departed brothers and sisters, and all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, and kindly give us your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ the Lord, who bestowed on the world of all his good. Through him and with him and in O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Each other in the side.
way that's into the world, bless the most called to suffer the land.
Lord, I am worthy to share my roof, but I won't say a word, my soul shall be.
Thank you.
can say together that because of first not us, we can have the capital of God, first of the news. The Lord, my God, keep my heart as they say, where is my God to see you? Where is my God to find you? You have made me and remade me. And so around me, all the good things I possess. This is the only time for you. I have not yet done that for the first time. Teach me to see you. Please stay with the present of people who pray, O Lord, and lead those who have viewed the heavenly mysteries to pass in formal ways to the newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have some announcements. The first one is about the levity. As we continue to answer our Montana bishops' call to defend life, ask Christ to grant the conversion of hearts that we, and all Montanans, that recognize and respect the infinite dignity of each human life and reject the radical abortion initiative, CIO 28. Life cherished and protected from conception to a natural death is a tenet of our Catholic faith. Upon this tenet rests our insistence that each person must be regarded with the infinite dignity bestowed on them by our Creator. Regardless of a person's life, circumstances, past choices, or differences, their life is a precious gift. Defending life, especially the lives of those most vulnerable, we recognize and honor Christ in each and every person. Along with prayer in our families and outreach mass, Montana bishops are now inviting all the faithful to adopt some form of abstinence on these days, giving up meat for the days and traditional form of abstinence, prayerfully sacrificing a comfort or pleasure of one's own choosing, as in keeping with the observance as we seek God's mercy and special protection from the Lord. This optional observance will continue until the threat of CIM 28 is addressed, possibly until voting in November. Other announcements. Please consider signing up to make materials for our Catechesis of the Good Shepherd program that will begin in the fall. Five or six spots that need to be filled, especially the new workers. And then to sign up is in the bulletin to call Don in the parish office. Please consider serving as a member of the Pastoral Council or Finance Council. See the bulletin for more information. One of the council members in the pastor or finance council. And there will be a farewell gathering from this down to July 24th at 12:10 Mass. And after the final blessing, we move in our Father, Hail Mary, and glory be the Father, for great respect of life and the Lord God. The Lord be with you.